Hi everyone, welcome back to my channel for another interesting review. Thanks for watching, this time with another Pils from Oberfranken. This one is from Brauerei Gasthof Wischert, located in Lichtenfels. Founded 1863. Really, really small brewery. Annual output is 3,000 hectoliters per year. This is their Pils, which is their most sold one. It looks like this, and it's really, really something that I've been looking forward to a lot. It's their classic one, and I really like the look. I like the look of the label. Gives a really nice and old impression. Here is the top cap also. Private brewery, says the cap, and no back label. But look of this label, isn't this looking really classical and nice? Wischert Edelpils. Brauerei Abfüllung. And it says right here, Brauerei Wischert, Lichtenfels, Oberwallenstadt. Wischert Edelpils alcohol content 4.9% volume, which is the normal for a pils. Zutaten Wasser, Gerstemalz, Hopfen, Hopfenextrakt. That's all information that it is here on the label. Nothing more. And yeah, really, really nice impression this brewer has been giving from Oberfranken. It's a pils, and this brewer is known for its pils and for their nice food and nice Biergarten also. I'm gonna give you the link to the brewer's website in the description box below, of course. Also, I've heard that they stopped brewing some years ago, and that the beer nowadays is brewed Lohngebraut, brewed under license by Pilsbräu Weissmann. Unfortunately, they had some other beers before. I don't think that they have them any longer, but I think it was the Kellerbier, Dunkel and the Doppelbock, which is a seasonal one, but I think that this is the only one that it's left and still with the Wischert name. As you know, I have some books also with information about bears from Franconia, which is the region that I'm interested in right now. I'm interested in the region Franconia and the Franconia bears, which really is the best ones in the world, and also the Vielfalt, which is the means how many different bear types there is. I've been showing you some different ones lately, and there are gonna be more different bear types from the Franconian brewers that I'm into right now. Here we have one book that is really, really nice, and we have right here, I guess, Tof Wischert, and I'm gonna give you some information about that, of course. Der übrig gebliebene Braumeister Michael Wischert war lange der letzte Brauer in der deutschen Korbstadt Lichtenfels. Die 1863 gegründete Brauerei hat so bekannte Namen wie Bürgerbräu, Rauch und Wickle später überlebt und ist dank der guten Zusammenarbeit von Mutter Josephine Michael und seinem Bruder Rainer Wischert ein echtes Klöner in der fränkischen Bierkultur geblieben. Die Fans kommen vor allem aus dem Coburger Raum, wo die Brauereidichte noch geringer geworden ist und man einfach mal ein fränkisches Landbier genießen möchte. Dank der neuen Autobahn ist man ja auch in wenigen Minuten da. Biersorten Wischert Edelpils und Kellerbier. Saisonal Doppelback, der Klassiker Wischert Edelpils. And there is also some information about the Brauerei Gasthof Wischert. Yeah, this is a real nice book. This one, I can recommend it to you. I also have another book about all brewers in Franconia, of course. I'm gonna show you that one too as well. Looks like this, and here we have Wischert, and you can see the beautiful beer garden right here, and also some information about the brewery here, of course. Lichtenfels Oberwellenstadt, founded 1863, Biersorten Pils und Dunkels, Brauerei Gasthof Wischert. But I'm gonna give you some information about the brewery that I found on their website, which, as I said, I'm gonna link to in the description box below. Nicolas Pabst laid the foundation stone for his brewery on the old Reichstrasse as early as 1863. In 1920, his son Johann handed over the brewery and inn to Wolfgang Fischer. In 1932, Johanna Fischer took over the business. In 1940, the current owner company name is mentioned for the first time, Brauerei Johanna Fischer, Inhaber Anna Wischert. When it was handed over to her son, Hans Wischert, in 1970, the brewery was called Brauerei Wischert, Inhaber Hans und Anna Wischert. After his death in 1996, his wife Josephine Wischert took over the business with her sons Michael and Rainer, which was then converted into Brauerei Gasthof Wischert, which is the name still today. The brewery Bear Garden. The Bear Garden is open from May 1st when the weather is nice. Forget everyday life and take a snack and a beer in the Bear Garden and let the day end. The brewhouse. The heart of every brewery is the brewhouse. The simplest type is the two device brewhouse. It consists of the combined mash and loader tun and the mash brew pan. A distinction is made between decoction and infusion process when brewing. While in the infusion process, the entire contents of the brew kettle are heated during the mash. In the decoction process, partial mashes are drawn and cooked. By maintaining defined temperatures during the breaks, the malt starch is broken down by enzymes into fermentable and non-fermentable sugars. The breakdown of the starch is checked with iodine samples. Then the first wort is separated from the spent grain by the lautering. The remaining extract is leached out of the spent grains by pouring water over them. The resulting pan is full seasoning approximately 90 minutes by adding hops. The undissolved hop components and the precipitation protein together, they are called hot trub, are removed from the wort. This is, takes place in the whirlpool formerly on the refrigerated ship in which the wort is set in rotating by being introduced tangentially, and the trub settles like a cone in the middle of the vessel. Due to the centripetal force, the clear wort can now be drawn off the side. The fermentation cellar, the hot wort is then cooled, finally aerated, and with the addition of yeast pumped into the flotation tank previously in the pitching tub. The resulting chill is removed by subsequent pumping into a fermentation tank. The fermentable malt sugar produced in the brewhouse is converted into alcohol and carbonic acid by the yeast enzymes. The resulting heat is dissipated through cooling zones that are welded to the tank and filled with ice water. The main fermentation with the cold fermentation process takes about 7 to 8 days. The storage cellar. After main fermentation, the green beer is the Jungbier is hosed into the storage tanks. The storage tanks are under pressure during maturation so that the resulting carbonic dioxide is bound with the beer. The secondary fermentation usually takes 3 to 4 weeks. Then the beer can be filtered and filled into kegs or bottles. We have owned the inn with our brewery since 1863. The stylish rooms, you will get to know real Franconian hospitality and comfort. In the shade of many chestnut trees, our cozy beer garden invites you to linger with a drinkable beer and a hearty snack. With these pictures, we would like to give you a small impression of our house. We offer our guests excellent home-style cuisine, our well-known good Wischert Pils and slightly smoky-tasting dark Kellerbier are served. Our premises are ideal for company outings and family celebrations. Sufficient parking spaces are always available. A multitude of marked hiking trails opens up charming landscape with famous sites such as Schloss Banz, 14 Heiligen, Staffelberg, to just name a few. It is not for nothing that the land of the Franks is so often praised in poetry and song. That's about it with this brewery, Brauerei Gasthof Wischert Edel Pils. And finally, it's time to try the Edel Pils from Wischert. And It's located in Lichtenfels in Oberfranken, the home of breweries. And I'm gonna use this glass, which is a glass that mostly looks like the Vichard's own glass regarding the shape. So, really interesting moment when I was looking up a label of Vichard Edel Pils. Isn't this looking really, really nice with the color combination? An old style looking label, in my opinion, old style looking bottle. Gonna be really nice to try this one, Vichard Edel Pils. So, finally, let's open up the bottle and pour it up. Very, very interesting moment, this, in my opinion. I've been looking forward to this a lot because what is better than a fresh, fresh pils? It was a while ago since I had a fresh pils, and look at this. I hope you can see all the small bubbles raises up and the big three finger compact white crown. Very important to build up that, especially in a pils. It's very, very important in a pils. Keeps the right taste in the glass, and it's also really, really something that you always see. Also, it's a quality sign with this thick, thick white crown. Let's get the aroma. And it's just so fantastic. I mean, what can I say? This is why I love pils so much. Strong hops taste, really, really, really fresh. You know what I'm talking about, this very, very fresh summer hops taste. You really feel the high quality hops in this one. It's really, really amazing in my opinion. Look at this. I mean, this pils definitely doesn't disappoint. The color of it is really, really Strohgelb, as they say in German, which is very pale yellow, and the foam, which is very important, is very, very thick and perfectly white. This is looking amazing. The Vichert Edel Pils, and I bet it's gonna be tasting really, really nice. So I'm gonna put this one right here. The Vichert Edel Pils. Look at this, how beautiful it's looking. Finally, I'm gonna try it. The Vichert Edel Pils. High expectations of it from this very, very small brewery. So let's taste it. Post. Of course, fantastic. I mean, this one is amazing in its pils taste. It has everything which I want from a pils. While I drink a pils, especially a German pils, which is the only things that I'm drinking, I only drink German beers, is the hops taste, the hops flavor that is so dominant and so strong, and that's what you want from a pils. It's as simple as that, and this one is really, really well balanced, really, really high quality in the raw materials and the brewing process, easy to fill. And pils is one of my favorite beer styles, I must say. And this one, Vichert Edel Pils, really, really describes and shows why I love pils so much. Still can see the thick white crown that isn't dusted here. Keep it all the way through while I drink the pils. That's very important. Keeps the right taste in the beer. And still all the small bubbles rising up, also showing quality, of course. This one is very, very fantastic. I understand why it's been so loved and why it's their most popular beer. The Vichert Edel Pils is really, really something special. And it's really, really a nice pils. I absolutely love this one. The pils flavor of it is perfect. You know what I'm talking about, as I said. The strong, grassy, dry hops bitterness, that's what it's all about. And that is really, really nice in this one. I can just imagine how well it can taste in their own beer garden, hot summer day. The pils is the most refreshing thing you can have. Really, really fits the summer very nice. So This one is really amazing. Bishop Edel Pils. I hope you can find it and try it because it's a very, very nice pils. Yep. As you can see, really it's a good drink also, and the taste very, very nice. So my recommendation is Bishop Edel Pils. How fresh it tastes. It's really, really amazing. And I can only recommend it to you. We need to support these small breweries. That's having a hard time right now. With the lockdown, they're not allowed to be open, their Gasthof and their restaurant. They're only allowed to sell the bottled beers. So that's of course a hard time. But my goal is of course to support them with showing their beers in my channel, give them attention and so on. Hopefully you can contact them and order beers. These family businesses is very, very small, so they often don't sell their beers in Getränkemarkt, which is normal beer shops that you can visit. They don't have the time to transport the beer to those shops. Many of these breweries doesn't even have a website. This website was updated last year, 2008, so it's very old looking, and that's what I like, because it shows that it's old style. They focus on brewing a good beer, not focus on sitting in front of a computer or anything like that. Traditional old Bavarian style, not being so interested in computers, but doing good beers instead. So one last look at the label. Bishop Edel Pils is a very, very great pils. I can really recommend it to you. That's it for now, I think. I hope you've been enjoying my review, and that you continue to follow my channel for more interesting beer reviews, and see you again in next Franconian beer review.